Today, I'm gonna show how you can get probably to one of the most hard to get location in Elden Ring. I'm talking about the Moonlight Altar and this cathedral. The Cathedral of Manus Celes, I hope I pronounced the name right. And let me tell you from the start, this is gonna be pretty complicated because you have to do most of the Runis quest, but I am very sure that you can be here. And don't worry, you want to be here, because here you can take one of the best summon spirit, here you can complete the Runis questline and a lot of other type of items you can get from that location. And yes, that is a part of the game. First things first, you have to reach Runis Rise. And from this location, we're gonna start the quest. In this video, I'm not gonna show you the full quest because I already have a video with that, 1 hour long video. If you want to do it step by step, there is the complex and the every single thing that you have to do. Here are only the major things, and how you can get through this quest and to get to that location. That is the main idea of this video, to get to the Moonlight Altar and to that cathedral. Now, you're gonna talk with Rani right over here, and she's gonna give you a little backup story. She's gonna get you up to date, and the next thing that you want to do is to just go down here in this building and talk with all those shadows. You're gonna see 3 different shadows of Blight, Iji, and Seluvis. I hope I pronounced the name right. But again, that is only a context. Then, the next thing that you want to do is to defeat Radahn. This is very important because after you're gonna defeat Radahn, you're gonna open a new world, and there, not a new world, a new area of the map, and only there you can get a certain item from for Rannis to continue her quest. I have to tell you from the start, sorry if my English is not perfect, but I am very sure that you can understand me. Now, this is gonna, here in this location, you're gonna start the fight with Radahn. Radahn, it's a main boss in this game, very, very important. And you cannot reach those location without defeating Radahn. But definitely you want to defeat this guy, because again, it's a very important part of the game. It's one of the main bosses in this game. You're gonna get a great rune. And, okay. This fight, it will not be that hard. I have a video on my channel how you can start the fight, how you can find him. And if you like, I have to repeat, you can watch that 1 hour long video when I just did all the Runis quest. It's you're gonna see all the details there. As you can see, the stars are falling and the new area on the map is gonna be open for you to go. You're gonna unlock the Nokron City. Eternal City, I think it's called, and you want to make your way to the Nokron City. Obviously, I have a video on my channel how you can find that city if you don't know how to do it, but I'm gonna tell you what will be your next step, what you have to do next. From this Mimic Tear location, because here is gonna be a very important location, all you have to do is to travel until you will find the item for Rani. I'm talking about the Finger Slayer's Blade. And yes, you have to reach a certain site of grace. I'm gonna show you right now the last site of grace until you're gonna take that knife. It's very, very important. It's a very important location. Make your way to the Knight's Sacred Ground. And from this location, all you have to do is to go straight ahead from that site of grace. Take that Celeste. Okay, you're gonna find some items right over here that you can take. Really important items. And bro, a lot of enemies. Now, enter into the building that it's on at the end of this road. Okay, that giant is gonna try to kill you. Take the Finger Slayer Blade, this is the important item, and the Great Ghost Glovewort. Then, go at Rannis again. Give her the Finger Slayer's Blade. It's very important to do that. You're gonna get the Carrion Inverted Statue. And now finally you can go to the final location underground in order to reach the secret location. For me it's a secret location because not the easiest thing to do, as you can see in this video. Now go to the Rena's Rise, which will be just up there at the Rani's Rise, just a little bit up there. And with that inverted statue right over here, you're gonna be teleported to the Ainsel River. from this Ainsel River, you're gonna get the miniature running from this location. You can talk at the first sight of Grace with her, but again, this is a part of the quest. If you want to, if you are curious and if you want to see all the quests, I will really advise you to watch that on my channel. I'm gonna put that link in this video description. Then make your way to the Noxtella Eternal City. After you're gonna reach Noxtella, very close it will be this guy, the Beowulf, I don't know how to pronounce the name, the shadow of that wolf. It looks like Blade. And defeat him, because it's very important to defeat this wolf. You're gonna get a key, the discarded palace key. Just go to that elevator, unlock the Lake of Wrath, site of Grace, and from this location we have to go back to the Renala. By the way, you have to defeat Renala in order to complete this quest, and go back to Renala right over here. Again, this is a part of the quest, a very important one. And with the discarded palace key, you can open now the chest that it's staying, that is right over here, this chest. From this chest, you're gonna get the Ring of the Full Moon. I think that is the name, let's see. The Dark Moon Ring. I never know the names in this game. And with this Dark Moon Ring, you will be able to reach the last location, because this, again, this item is very, very important. Now, let's move on. Just go down here. Keep going down. And then go right over here, go on the left. We have to reach the Astel, the natural born of the void, or something like that. That will be the name of that boss that we have to defeat. And yes, now we have to defeat the final boss in order to get to our location, to our secret and full of surprises location, let's call it that. Right over here, after you wanna take that coffin, okay, just enter to this wall, defeat Astel. It will be a quite of a fight, not the easiest fight, but I have a video on my channel how I defeat this guy very, very easy. Actually, two videos with this one, two different methods. And the next step is to reach the Astel site of Grace. It's gonna be right over here, a site of Grace. This site of Grace from the Astel, natural born of the void. And then just go to this cave underground area until you're gonna find an elevator. If this will be locked for you, is because you don't have the Ring of the Moon. Very simple. That's why I just showed you every single step that you have to do to be here. The final step is to take this elevator, and you're gonna be there finally. From this location, all you have to do is to explore to get to finish the Rani's quest line, because there at that cathedral you can finish the Rani's quest line, and you're gonna get a really awesome sword, the great sword, the magical great sword. But now you have just reached the Moonlight Altar, and the cathedral is just in front of you. This is exactly how you can be here. Okay, thank you so much for watching. You can hit that like button, subscribe, share, press the notification bell if you want more videos like this. And why not, I'm gonna see you in the next video. Tell me if I missed something, but probably not. And for the last time, I know I'm repeating myself, but I have to remind you, if you have trouble with something on this path, go ahead and watch my full video with Rani's questline. It's separated with chapters, and if you just have trouble with something, just go ahead and watch that. Thank you, be safe, and see you soon. Bye.